Hi there. Welcome back to the reboot of Modern Infrastructure Wednesdays. I'm Laura, your host, and today we're going to talk about upgrade strategies for your infrastructure. We'll be building on GCP, or Google Cloud, with Python and Pulumi. You can use any of these strategies and details with whatever cloud you like, or whatever language is supported by Pulumi. So the official ones, if you're keeping track, are TypeScript or JavaScript, Go, C#, and as we'll see, Python. Let's say that you have a bunch of infrastructure up and running in production. First, let's take a quick diversion. We're gonna talk about upgrade strategies. We're gonna use this diagram right here to talk a little bit about it. When we're wanting to upgrade a set of infrastructure, there's many paths we can take, and with a Pulumi program, we generally think about things just as we would think about deploying an application, like a new version of an application. One common path is called a blue-green deployment. In a blue-green deployment, there's a current set of infrastructure or a current application that we're going to refer to as the blue infrastructure. This blue deployment or blue infrastructure is currently running. It's running just fine in production, but we want to upgrade it to a new version. So what do? We stand up or commission an entirely new set of nearly identical infrastructure or a nearly identical application using the new version of whatever we're trying to do. We stand that up alongside of it, and that is called your green deployment or your green infrastructure. Once it's stood up, we verify it, make sure that it's working as we expect it to, and then we switch all of the traffic off of the blue deployment. Once we're sure that the green deployment is working properly under load, you then take down the blue deployment. The colors don't actually matter. I honestly have called it rainbows and unicorns deployments before. No one really cares. The idea, though, is that we really don't want to tear down existing infrastructure without being sure that the new infrastructure is working properly and without moving all of our traffic over, because we don't want a user to actually experience anything different. They should just see the upgrade and, oh look, hey, that's awesome, it works. A wiring error, whether virtual or physical, can really wreak havoc on your weekend if you deploy a new set of infrastructure and shove an application onto it without verifying that it actually works before tearing down the infra that had been working quite nicely. Thank you very much. I've been there. It's not fun by any stretch of the imagination. There's other deployment strategies too, like canary releases. Canary releases slowly move traffic over to new infrastructure. So you would do the same thing where you have a current set of infrastructure, you build up a new set of infrastructure that has the new version, but instead of actually just switching all the traffic over like you would flip on a light switch, instead you're sitting there and saying, I'm only going to send maybe 5% of my traffic over or 10% of my traffic over, using some kind of load balancing system, depending on how exactly you build it. This shares the load across deployments rather than making that complete shift, which can be great if you're trying out something new, like a new method of load balancing across your infrastructure. You slowly increase the load and measure your capacity while having this like safe spot to go back to should everything always go sideways. Pulumi itself has a create before delete strategy, which basically means that it creates a resource, tests that it works by making sure the rest of the deployment all works together, and then deletes the old resource by after moving all of the traffic over. So this isn't exactly a blue-green deployment, because you're not actually standing up the entire set of infrastructure altogether. However, you can kind of think of it more like a micro blue-green deployment, because each individual resource is getting that update. It stands up the new resource, moves over the wiring, validates that it's working, then tears down the old resource, and repeats that process for any resource that needs to get actually updated. That's pretty neat. That being said, though, enough about just diagrams and stuff. Let's go look at some code. All right, and here we are with our code. This is a fairly basic web server. This is this little startup script here that says bin bash hello world. So when we actually curl the endpoint in the end, we'll get just hello world. That's really how we know it works. The application here doesn't matter though. We're talking more about the infrastructure. So let's kind of move forward a little bit here. You'll see that over here, other way, you'll see that over here, you will see the compute image. So we are using Debian 9 right now. We're going to actually move up to Debian 11 because that's available. That's the update we'll actually do. We have a network and subnet and a global address and a firewall. Basically, all of this together is putting together our network so that we have a IP address that we're going to hit no matter what. We'll see we'll have a proxy a little bit later as well, along with a forwarding rule. But all this really is all going to do, all of the networking pieces just say, hey, when we have all of these instances of compute, which we'll show in a moment, all of those are going to get mapped somewhere, and they're going to lead just to a single IP address that we're not assigning to a specific compute instance, because if you do that, you can't reuse it, so you wouldn't actually be able to update in place. So instead, we're going to just have this one that's out there that we're setting that then uses some load balancing to get to. So that's where we have all of this information here. We do have port 80 open. That's just because we're using HTTP, because we're just doing a quick curl. This is not going to stand up very long. We do have a health check, because it's always good to have a health check. Basically, this says, is everything up and running and healthy and ready to go? And here's our instance template. This is where it gets a little bit interesting. We have a tiny, tiny little machine we're asking for. There you go, we're right over here. And there's the startup script, which is that little simple HTTP server that we're calling. The disk here is using the source image that we defined up above. So this is where we're actually going to be changing that little bit. And it's just saying, here's our network interface and make sure it allows a health check. We have a group manager. And this is, again, pretty standard if you're familiar at all with Google Cloud. The versions here just says use the instance template for it. We have port 80 open. And then here's this update policy. This update policy is actually really important because otherwise, if you don't set an update policy, you can update the template all you want. The VMs will not update, the virtual machines will not actually update until it does something, until you knock it over or otherwise go into the UI and actually hit replace or into the CLI and send a replace request. So in this case, we have a minimal action of restart because in general, if there's a change, we don't necessarily want to restart all of our virtual machines and rebuild them because that can be a little bit invasive when it comes to keeping everything up and running and your user sees nothing. So we actually are using restart in this case. What it'll do is that's the minimum action. We'll see that it'll actually replace our VMs when we run the update because there's actually a change to the underlying image. So we do want a proactive change, though. That means that whenever there's a change, it's going to try to do something to the VMs. There's another one called opportunistic, which basically says if there's something else like that happens, great, we'll update things while we get there. Otherwise, we're not going to do anything. That's not all that helpful in this case, so that's why we're using proactive. And in this case, we really only want one VM unavailable at a time. That way the user doesn't experience anything different because we have two total VMs. And we'll get a chance to see that in the UI here in just a moment. Then we have a backend service. This backend service is basically acting as our load balancer along with the rest of our networking. So you'll see that it's talking about an external load balancing scheme. It's sending everything through HTTP, and it's going directly to the instance group. That's the manager that you see up above. We have a URL map and a proxy and a forwarding rule. All of this, again, is just setting it up so that we have one address that we're going to be able to hit to actually get where we want to go. And we're sending it to port 80 again. And then last but not least, this is the nice thing about Pulumi. We are programmatically getting all of this information once it's created so that we can use it as we go. So right now, and you'll be able to see that I've already run this once, we're going to actually run that curl on our stack. There's that hello world. Now, let me just quickly flip over to demonstrate where we are. All right, so this is our group manager that's currently up and running, so you can see everything here. Let's drill down into one of these VMs. It's going to take a moment to load. And when we actually take a look at this, we'll scroll all the way down here. Here's the instance. It's running off that instance template. We have everything there. There's the subnet. You'll note that it is under Debian 9. This is the piece that we are about to go fix. So let's actually go and do that. All right, we are going to go up to our code here. Let me see. Let's go change that code. Scroll all the way to the top. There we are. And we want to just change this to Debian 11. Always make sure to save. And then we're going to do a Pulumi up. And when we're actually doing this Pulumi up, we'll get our preview. So we're going to take a look at that real quick. You'll notice the incident template is getting replaced. The group manager is getting updated. So let's take a look at those details. And again, here's the instance template getting updated in various places. The source image is getting changed to 11 bullseye, which is great. That's exactly what we want. So let's hit yes, and we're going to see everything go live. Now let's flip over while this is actually going through. We're going to flip over and go take a look at our instance here, and we're going to go back and take a look at our actual instance here getting updated. So we should see, we have a status of updating already. That's a good sign. So we'll see this instance actually change. So we're gonna see a little bit of moving magic here, and we're gonna let everything update. All right, and as you can tell, you can see the difference in creation time. So this later one is using the new instance template. So we can see that it's in the process of deleting the old one, making sure that it's up and running. So as we go through here, we can tell that there it is, Debian 11. I hope you enjoyed this episode of Modern Infrastructure Wednesday as we explored some update strategies that you can do with your infrastructure and tried a little bit of GCP code while we were at it. If you like this video and want to see some more, please do like and subscribe to our channel, and also check out the Modern Infrastructure Wednesday playlist. Also, if you want to see something specific, some type of build that you haven't seen yet with Pulumi, please do leave me a note down in the comments. I do read them, so let me know what you would like to see. And on that note, thanks so much for tuning in, and I'll see you in 2 weeks. Take care.